You are totally full of and these guys are going down in two because of it.
This ain't got nothing to do with going down no mother.
I'm not listening to your bull. Either he's gone or I'm gone.
Why do I take your hands off?
Back in the kitchen, the orders are pouring in.
You need a cup of gumbo?
Right behind.
That's ice cold.
What?
Nothing worse than cold gumbo, man.
Yes, you're right.
I decided to taste the gumbo. The gumbo wasn't heated up properly. It's bad. The gumbo's sour. Sour? So throw it out and make new one.
It's not a good gumbo. Like, I don't think the chef knows how to make it, right? Like, I can't stomach it. I can't finish it.
I'm gonna throw up. I just think the gumbo is so bad, make me puke. It's their fault they should be tasting the food. They need to throw it out, make new one, because they're gonna make everybody sick. Did you taste the gumbo?
No, I haven't tasted it.
It's bad. I just throw up.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. How long that gumbo been out?
We take it out of the freezer and we pre-thaw it.
In water.
And have it sit here.
Did you bring it to temperature? Every time you eat something, you need to make sure you bring it to 212 degrees. Otherwise, that's how bacteria grow.
The CDC estimates that 48 million Americans get sick from foodborne illnesses each year, and 3,000 of those cases result in death.
Oh. I taste that gumbo, now my whole stomach's up. Cause which idiot's not that? How many people does this guy make sick?
Guys, we gotta have a talk here. I wanna hear what happened with this soup.
We took the stuff back out of the steam table and I guess we didn't let it set out long enough to cool off the right way.
You guys knew it wasn't up to temperature, right? Right?
Yes.
And
yes.
You sold it anyway, correct?
I wasn't aware that it wasn't up to
temperature. Am I right or wrong?
Mr. John, I was not aware there wasn't enough potato. I was never
supposed to be aware. That's what you get paid for.
You're correct. You're
okay,
correct.
Next. Chef, how many times did you throw up tonight, Chef?
About 3 times.
Close this kitchen down now. You don't have the right to sell food. Damn you. How dare you get people sick? Shut this kitchen down. I don't want any food served here tonight. Do you hear me? Close it the f- down.
About doing this because our priority is never to get anybody sick.
No food comes out of this kitchen until we know we're honest and we're safe. Is that reasonable?
It's reasonable.
That soup went out to other people, didn't it? Didn't it?
It went out to one person, yes.
So we got other people sick.
What do you say?
I apologize from the bottom of my heart. It was neglect.
I've never been as angry in my life as I was at Jeff tonight, but I'll tell you what, it opened his eyes. He apologized to me. That tells me Jeff has a spine. If he has a spine and an open mind, I can train him.
Let me just get a burger.
How do you want it cooked?
Medium.
Okay, so we got a club sandwich.
There's no POS system, so they're handwriting checks. So is there a concern of how long the check's been in?
All right.
Okay, cool. Just got it. All right, great, cool.
Oh, at least we're going to cook our bacon.
You know what this guy's doing?
Right after he touched the raw bacon, there's our onion.
Now the raw is on the cutting board. Bingo, health violation. There we go.
Those the patties.
Frozen burger
patty. Frozen.
Look at it. It's freezer burn. Did you see the white?
How long does it take to cook a burger patty?
A medium burger? 8 minutes. So the burger has yet to move.
Hasn't even touched it yet.
Come on, show me what you're gonna do to the burger there, brother. Leave it where it is.
Just right there.
You don't touch that. You're good, man.
He's turned the burger, Roberto. Dude, flip the burger.
Flip the burger, Roberto.
This guy won't flip this burger.
Oh my God, the burger. Oh my God, did he flip the burger?
Yeah. See, now you've got all the grease and all the fat, and we have a burger that's a medium burger that's been on the grill for 13 minutes.
I'm dying to see when he takes a bite of that burger.
I want to hear the crunch.
Roberto, I'm Jon Taffer.
Hello, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I saw you put a hamburger on a grill.
Yeah.
And I watched you for 14 minutes not turn that hamburger over. The hamburger was burnt. The guests couldn't eat it. The reason why you're not selling food, I think, is that you're lazy. And for a guy who's been working in a kitchen 19 years, you know better.
No, this is not the f***ing army, okay? Don't talk to me like that.
Let me tell you what he does, Sal. He goes into the refrigerator, he pulls out a raw piece of bacon, puts it on a cutting board with your bare hands, raw pork. Then a couple of minutes later, he puts the salad right on top from where the pork was. You didn't wash your hands? You didn't wash
yes,
the cutting board?
No, you did
what
not.
Every time,
no, you
every
did
every
not.
Time I wash my hands,
you're
right
lying. You did
every
not.
Time I wash
you're
my
lying.
What happens when you put raw pork on lettuce and send it out in the dining room? What happens, Roberto?
Oh, yeah, it gets contaminated.
It's irresponsible and it's illegal.
In 19 years, nobody got sick here.
You don't know that. Food poisoning can happen in an hour, or it can take days. Roberto has cross-contamination all over this kitchen, so I don't know how many people have gotten sick here.
This device measures bacteria content on surfaces.
Okay. So okay. The only thing
so
that...
So this device is gonna check, and I'm gonna see right now whether we're getting people sick or not. Any count over 2,500 is a failure.
I'm just touching surfaces that a hand would touch. We have 199,308 counts of bacteria, which is a failing grade.
So guess what you're doing tonight? You're cleaning a kitchen like you should have. You clean a kitchen, I come back tomorrow. Chef, we go through this whole place with the swab tomorrow. If it isn't clean, I'll get a cook who will clean it, and it won't be you.
If you want to fire this, Sal, you can fire me.
Listen to
this. Don't talk to me like that because I'm not f***ing.
What I care about is your irresponsible
you know what?
And lazy.
You know what? F*** you.
You say f*** you to me? You don't like it, walk the f*** out of here. You want me to treat you like a man? Act like one tonight.
You gotta clean the whole kitchen.
I don't supposed to do the cleaning here. I'm...
So this isn't your responsibility?
You're supposed to keep it clean.
You don't want to do it.
Burgers. Come on, John, where the burgers at?
Where is the burger?
John has no voice in this kitchen. Chef, you have to tell him where the food's going.
The most important thing about being a leader is to speak up.
Let's make it clear. Them burgers about ready. I'm about to put cheese and bacon on.
But Q has been helping both people and both stations. And I think he wants to step up.
How many bacon burgers we got?
All together, you got one whale.
How many I got all day?
All day, Chef. All day means all of it.
You got two whale, one whale. You got
how many burgers all day? Like, how many burgers I got?
Three.
There's something wrong with the hood in this place.
John, is this hood always like this? I mean, the whole place is filled with smoke.
Pretty much, when it gets that busy, our vent hood fan does not work properly at all.
I can see. I mean, it's not pulling the smoke out of here. We got a major
ain't
issue.
Ain't nobody turned them on.
The hood?
Yes. That's why it ain't working. Ain't nobody turned it on.
So we've been cooking all night long, never turned the hood on. Unbelievable. I have never, ever had a kitchen manager not turn the hood on before.
It doesn't make me angry. No, that suits me just fine.
What the hell's the matter with you? This is responsibility as a chef. For Christ's sakes. This is a totally disorganized kitchen, and you are not a leader. John, he couldn't do one thing tonight in that kitchen. He couldn't manage. He couldn't get tickets out. This guy is worthless. So I'm shutting it down.
Okay.
We can't pull it off. Go behind the bar and shut it the hell down.
Starving.
I really think it's a long time to be waiting for some fish and chips.
Quality kitchens always maintain a 12-minute ticket time, and that's what I expect from trained chefs. They blew it, and they're gonna hear from me. The same frickin' ticket is here. It's now been here for, you ready? 36 minutes ticket times. We blew it, guys, we blew it, come on. Dig us out now, get us out of here with some dignity. Now you see why I call it a stress test. So let's start with the kitchen, because I just can't believe what I saw in that kitchen when you think that we're surrounded by professional chefs, Nick.
We've got 36-minute ticket times. I'm appalled, I'm disgusted.
The kitchen was a disaster.
I don't know where to go from here.
Chris, this is too important, it'll take me a minute. I've been watching this cooler all night long. Those doors open every 5 to 10 seconds. So what do you think the temperature is in here?
probably say 40 degrees.
Nick, I want you to put a thermometer in that chicken.
What temperature should this chicken be at?
41 or below.
Are you guys aware that this is at 44 degrees?
I'm not. I was not aware about it.
Try the ribeye.
John, this is at 45 degrees.
Chef, what happens to meat when it's at 45 degrees?
It's building bacteria right now.
That will get people sick. As a professional, I'm ashamed of both of you. Throw this away. Anytime proteins like that are over 40 degrees, bacteria grows. I made them throw away all of their protein. Hundreds and hundreds of dollars. They frickin' deserve it.
Fight my ass, dude. Hey, Mitch, you want to put all this? Just dump it. I'm not going to throw all this meat away. So I might as well take the $200 bills and throw them in the trash can. Let's just put it back into the region. Chris definitely tried to hold on to the chicken. He tried to salvage some money. He's more interested in a couple dollars than getting somebody sick.
Three simple beers, guys. Three simple food items. We just totally unraveled. Then here's the kicker that really got me. The chicken in that walk-in is 44 degrees. What did he say in the kitchen? Where did he tell you to put that chicken?
In the region.
He told you to put it in the region in the back, because he'll sell it anyway, won't he? Won't he?
Yep.
This guy was gonna take that chicken that would get you sick, put it back in the region. I heard you say it.
I did say it, then I changed my mind. I said, dump it, it's done.
Then you changed your mind, because you said what?
Throw in the trash.
If he wasn't there having integrity, Jimmy, he would have put that in the region, and you would have served it tomorrow, because you didn't know better.
Correct.
How dare you? You sold out your customers for about $60 worth of chicken. How do you feel as a chef and an owner when he does that, Mitch?
It's wrong, it's immoral, it's... I can't even.
Stick up for yourself, man. Tell him how you feel. You lost your house, man.
I'm at my wit's end. It's now or it's nothing. Because I have nothing. It's over. Chris and I used to be best friends. At this point, it's gonna be very hard to really gain back the trust and respect. Things will never be the same.
Guys, my name is Jon Taffer. Quickly, this is Brendan. Chef Brendan, he's gonna watch you guys for a while, okay?
Have we temped any of these ingredients over here?
Yes.
We need to be at 160. All this stuff that you've got over here, it's all too low temperature. You're gonna poison somebody.
What's going on?
Just letting it fester to the heat.
Did you bring this to a boil?
Yes.
Because I have cameras in here, give it to me straight.
No, I didn't. Nope.
Okay, you need to temp it.
You didn't.
No, I didn't. Nope.
Are you laughing?
No. All right,
I'm... Why are you smiling? Do you think it's funny to serve soup below temperature to somebody?
No, it's not.
Would you eat that soup below temperature?
No, I wouldn't.
Look at me when I'm talking to you. Is it appropriate to serve something below temperature to a guest? Yo, Mr. Cook, stop what you're doing and dump that soup down the drain now.
This should all be below 41. Not one of it. 60 degrees on this.
60 degrees?
60 degrees. All the temps are off. Chicken, what are we at here? 50 degrees. That's poisoning somebody.
Nobody gets sick when I'm in a building. Never, ever.
These are serious health violations. Do you understand? These are serious health violations. You're gonna shut this business down.
No, f*** you.
Quitter. No wonder why you're a failure.
Can I talk to you for a minute? You want to talk to me? I'm here to train you with a professional chef and make your life better. And this is the way we're going to start? This can be a good experience for you. Are you going to throw it all away? Is that what you want to do?
No, I don't want to throw it all away. I just don't like to be talked to like that.
Well, I don't like that you serve food below temperature and get people sick. Is that fair?
Wrong person.
It's a great example for your son. How he's gonna hear how his mom failed and then quit and drove away. Good example, Mom. Good work.
Diana couldn't handle it. She abandoned her son in the kitchen. She comes back tomorrow, she doesn't have a job. Shut it down.
Okay. So take a peek around, all right?
All right.
Is that good? Do you ever have a cleaning schedule?
No, it ain't no cleaning schedule.
How often do you clean the fryer?
I clean them every week.
Every week what?
Every once a week you clean both.
Every week.
You're full of
I find that hard to believe.
Well, you call me what you want to call me.
There's no way.
This is cleaning every week. Look at this.
Oh, my God.
I'm not even scraping it. I'm slicing it.
This is what the bacon was cooked on.
Oh.
Look, can you see this dripping down? How many times was the bacon cooked on this and served to people?
It ain't gonna be spotless, but it's clean.
If it's not spotless, it's not clean. Randy, is this clean to you?
No, that's not clean.
From now on, see her? She's gonna tell you what clean is.
What I do is what I do.
Well, what you do isn't good enough.
Well, to mine, it is.
I don't give a about
well,
yours.
I don't give a about yours.
Really? Well, then maybe you shouldn't be here.
Well, maybe I shouldn't.
Guys, either he's gonna clean this kitchen to my satisfaction, or I'm gonna leave. You better get him the hell in line.
But he ain't gonna come back here and talk to me like I ain't here. And I'll be
this, man.
Well, you can look at what you want.
What are you defending?
It ain't got nothing to do with a cook doing it.
Bull.
Bull.
Your kitchen, you clean it, man.
What?
You are totally full of. And these guys are going down in two because of it.
This ain't got nothing to do with going down no mother.
I'm not listening to your.
To your bull.
He's gone or I'm gone. Get out of my.
You better kick your hands off. Well, you better kick your hands off for me.
Get out of my face.
I ain't no.
Mr. Cook, you clean to her satisfaction. Welcome to the bar business.
Stop. That's enough. How long have you been here?
I've been here 18 years.
Okay. There's a reason you've been here 18 years.
I'm willing to do what I got to do to make this place successful. Hey. I care about Randy and Rick. You know, they're good people. This has been a management problem from the get-go. If ain't nobody jumping in to tell nobody to do this, to do that, ain't nobody gonna do it.
How do you order food over here?
You can order at the bar if you ever get to a bartender, or you can walk out to the truck.
Be with you in 1 sec.
Hey, Sherry, what did you order?
Fried burgers.
You got a two-burger app sampler order coming up?
I got two burgers coming up.
There was supposed to be a two-burger app sampler all together in one order.
Systems are breaking down.
Yes, I realize that.
We got Brian overwhelmed on the griddle and trying to take orders. He can't hold down the fort. We're sinking.
Missy, who ordered the app sampler?
I can't remember.
The ticket ordering system for this kind of crowd doesn't work. It's just getting no food out. The kitchen had a breakdown.
I had to go out and get my food. It took 25 minutes. The burger is not even what I ordered.
25 minutes you've been sitting here. What did you order?
A burger.
Burger. Let me check. Thanks. What's going on?
Crashing.
Is this his burger?
Yeah, this is his burger.
That's his burger? How come it took 25 minutes? When did you put it on? 7 minutes ago? That ticket sat for 18, 19 minutes before the burger even hit the grill?
No, that's not what happened.
Why didn't the burger drop the minute the ticket got up?
Go look to see how many
I've. When the ticket comes in, drop the food! Listen to me, listen to me.
No, you listen to me.
No, I don't listen to you. You listen to me. When the ticket goes up there, you put the food on the grill.
You get your ass.
Are you a cook or not?
Yes, I am a cook.
Come on, this is a Friday night, man. We're not even busy here and you're falling apart? Look at me.
I'm falling apart.
Keep it together.
I'm not falling apart. You
keep it together, man. And next time it happens, I'll fire your ass.
Hi, this is Jon Taffer. Click here to subscribe to Paramount Network on YouTube for more Bar Rescue.